Hi, I'm Dave McMahon. This is Natural Fitness Lab, and today we're going to teach you how to dress for minus 20 and below. All this here is going on this. So let's start at the bottom with a pair of socks. I like a mid-thickness, tight-knit weave of wool and synthetic fiber. You only need one pair of socks because you don't want to fill up the boots too much. You want a little bit of room. We also want to start with some underwear, windproofing underwear on the front. In some cases, I may double up on that with a little bit of thickness at the back as well. So that's the first layer that goes in. The next layer, closest to your skin, is this thin layer, but it has sort of a mesh. So the idea here with something like this is to keep or trap the air very close to your body, but also allow the moisture to wick away from your body and then into the other layers. So that's the top. I have a very similar thing with the bottoms. So you'll see a lot of mesh lining with some padding here. So that's the very nearest layer to your skin. Right across that, we place on the top your polypropylene synthetic fiber top. Fairly thin. Again, we're just layering in nice thin layers. And the bottoms, nice thin layer here. You can sort of see, so this would be the bottoms. On top of that, we'll put windproofing. So a windproofing layer. So this is all windproofing all in front with just a normal synthetic polypropylene layer of thin underwear, long underwear there. Same thing here on the tops. On the tops, I just go with a vest because I need some room to articulate my arms, so I don't want them restricted. So nice little vest again, only windproofing in the front because that's where you're going to get all the wind loading. So on top of all that, we want to pack it down close to your body. We also want to provide a little bit of aerodynamics, and so we put the ski suit. So specially designed Natural Fitness Lab ski suit. With some various panels of different thicknesses and textures. Provide good articulation as well as padding where you need the most, same with the top. So what you're trying to do is prevent any sort of loose clothing from moving around. You want that air trapped. You don't want it, the outside air moving in and out of your clothing. On top of that, I could probably race in that, but quite often I'll train with a long sleeve, very lightweight long sleeve top with a full zipper. So the idea of the full zipper allows me, when I'm going up a hill, I can do the zipper all the way down. When I go down the hill, I can do it all the way up. I can do that very quickly. It's very, very convenient. That's probably for racing or heavy training, that's all I'll be using. But if I'm going to warm up, or I'm going on a less arduous or less intense workout, I'll be probably wearing a jacket. So ski jacket, a little lighter material on the back, a little thicker in the front, but it's still fairly thin. Like it's not a huge jacket because you want to get stuck with that sort of thing when you're out on a long ski, you have nowhere to put it, unless you bring a pack, of course. On top of all that, then going to the car, what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to wear a nice warm-up jacket like this. In fact, maybe one or two, keep myself nice and warm on the way to the venue. I may also wear a warm-up pants, and I'll be able to take them off after the warm-up or after I commute. So on the hands, what I start with is glove liners, sort of a thin polypropylene glove liner. And then I put it into a glove. So you can, if it's really cold, you can go with mitts. I like these gloves because they're nice and puffy. They got good room, good articulation. And they also have a neat little feature here where I can put a little glove over mitt. And then when I get too warm, I just take this off and it tucks in right here into the mitt. The trick here with mitts is I buy them a little bit long so my fingers don't touch the end of the glove, and I give a lot of nice room, so lots of air that can be trapped in there. That's with the gloves. On my head, I'm going to start with a balaclava. So a fairly thin balaclava. On top of that, I'm going to put a mid-weight hat. So not, you don't want a huge hat because you're going to have to deal with that the whole, when you get on the ski, you're going to have to deal with the heat. I then cover that with a buff, that they can pull up over the hat, and I can bring that down as well. If it gets really cold, you can use tape across your nose, or you can try to Vaseline it up or use Dermatone or anything like this. What I like to do is I just take one of the buffs, I cut it in one third, and I just put it over top of my nose and my cheeks, and I can pull it down whenever I require. The beauty of that is it doesn't stick to you. It's also very thin, or you need just a thin layer. What you don't want to do is cover your mouth because it's going to be hard to breathe. Also, you're going to end up pushing all that moist air into your glasses and they're going to fog up. Talking of which, what you're going to do is you're going to have a nice pair of goggles like this, ideally the ones that can move up and down. So when you're climbing a hill, you can move them up. And then once you are starting to go into downhill, you can move them down. You want full UV protection in any sunlight so you don't get snow blindness or fry your retinas. On the boots, here's a nice set of boots. So with the boots, I try to get my boots one half size bigger, again, because I don't want my toes touching the end of the boots. I want a little bit of room in there so I trap some air, and I don't want to constrict the blood flow to my feet. If I get really cold, what I can do is I can also add some boot warmers. So you just slip these boot warmers over top. Those are the main ways of keeping your feet warm. If you really need, then you have heated sort of soles and things like this you can put in if you have problems with keeping your feet warm. Other little accessories that I'm going to have is if I want to carry more stuff, I may have just a little pack like this, or you can go with a larger pack. The beauty of this is it just adds more pockets for putting food and things like this without carrying a lot of weight. On my face, I'm going to apply sunscreen because even when it's cold and minus 20, you can get sunburn and cold protection. You can also get Lipso as well, that is UV protection. Going out in any given time, I'm going to have my pack. Inside my pack, I'm going to have an extra buff. I'm going to have food, my car keys, my pass, and thermoses for hot water or hot juice, and a few other sort of knickknacks like that. Nice packs, so never leave home without some extra food and water. My watch, so I record where I am and what I've done, because it doesn't count unless it's on Strava. If you're going out at night, you have two options for headlamp. So this is a headlamp, a variety of different power settings, so you don't have to blind everyone with the maximum setting. The other option, which is sort of nice in a snowstorm, is a light that goes on your waist because it acts like a flood lamp, or a fog lamp, I should say, and it keeps the beam out of your direct line of sight. Or you can use these two together and just choose as you go along as you want to do. So now you know how to dress.